Boker Tov to all watching here live. Just want to, before I touch a little bit on the Kuzari, those of you who live close to Griffin and off of Griffin in the Hollywood area, Rabbi Daniel Ben Arosh of Shuvah Israel and Ways of Israel, we'll be joining in the new minyan that's going to be starting up at 7 o'clock, so I will be very short and brief with this class this morning. I was glad to hear that the new time fits perfectly in my schedule. So be able to join the minyan there with Rabbi Daniel Ben Arosh of Shuvah Israel. Those of you who live close by, make it a point to come and visit Rabbi Daniel and be part of the community here. The address is 2490 Griffin Road, Fort Lauderdale, Florida, 33312. His phone number, those of you who wish to take it down, is 561-229-6264. Kama Shesh Echad Shtaim Shtaim Tesha Shesh Shtaim Shesh Arba. Again, that's 561-229-6264. Rabbi Daniel Ben Arosh, and he is with Shuvah Israel. We're going to be meeting there in the morning in a few minutes. For early morning prayer, shacharit, and so forth. I want to get right to what happened in the Kuzari. We're looking at the Kuzari, and we're on page 59. An interesting thing that the Kuzari now asks about this rule that the Kuzari, Rabbi Yehuda Levi, states that when we find that God spoke to Adam, who dwelt in another land, in Moshe in Egypt, and to Avraham in Ur Kasdim, and later on, Yeheskel and Daniel and Babel, Yirmiyahu in Egypt. I thought Hashem only spoke in the Eretz Israel. The Chacham now speaks, the Rabbi Yehuda Levi speaks in response. All of these prophecies were either concerning the Holy Land or for its sake. Avraham merited that God speak to him when he told him to go to the land and travel all over it. Prophecy was communicated to Yeheskel concerning the return of the Israelites to the land. Daniel was told about the destruction of the second Beit HaMikdash and the ingathering of the exiles in the future. All of these prophecies were thus given because of the land of Israel. Another reason for the communication of prophecy to Yehezkel and Daniel outside the land of Israel is that they lived when the first Beit HaMikdash still existed and witnessed the presence of the divine in the first HaMikdash and still existed and witnessed the divine revelation in it. And when this state of holiness prevailed, then anyone of the chosen Jewish people suitable of achieving prophecy was capable of receiving it. And whoever achieved prophecy in the Holy Land did not lose the status even when he left the Eretz Israel. As to God having spoken to Adam, this indeed was in the Holy Land, and it was which he created and where he died. This is according to our tradition that four couples, Adam, Chava, Avram, Sarah, Yitzchak, Rivka, Yaakov, and Leah, are buried in the cave of Machpelah. The land is also called before God's presence, and it is said concerning it, God's eyes are constantly upon it. That's in Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 12. The possession of the land was the object of jealousy between Cain and Hevel, and they made sacrificial offerings in order to learn which one of them would have the merit of possessing the land and who consequently would merit prophecy in the divine flow. And the chosen son of Adam, who would be the secondary, like the peel to the fruit. Cain killed Hevel, and the kingdom of the Holy Land remained without a ruler, as is written, and Cain departed from God's presence. Genesis chapter 4, verse 16. And wandered over the other lands. This is also stated concerning the prophet Jonah. Jonah rose away to Tarshish in from the presence of God. He ran away from the land of Israel, the local of prophecy. It was the area where prophecy was given, Eretz Israel. But he was returned to it when the fish cast him onto the land, and the second prophecy was in the land of Israel. When Seth was born, he was also of the image of Adam and suited for the title child of God, as was Adam and as perfect as the latter. As is written, and he gave birth in his image and in his form, Genesis chapter 5, verse 23. And he inherited all of Hevel's lofty attributes and served as his replacement, as it says, because God gave me the additional progeny as replacement for Hevel. Hevel took possession of that lofty land whose status is inferior of that to the paradise. Now we're going to pause here as we will continue. Bezalel Hashem, next tomorrow and continue this conversation that the Chacham is having with Khazari as to why there's a special status the land of Israel has that no other land has. And this is why there's such a dispute over the land. It belongs to the children of Israel, not the pseudo children called Palestinians. So that making it very clear, anyone who declares the land of Israel or trying to recreate a new state, a new pseudo state called Palestine, which never existed, except by the Philistines, which were Gentile invaders, occupiers, they are the occupiers, and they need to be settled somewhere else, as far as my opinion is concerned. Well, this is Rabbi Moshe Otero, and keep in tune with the ways of Israel, and come join us at Shuva Israel here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, off of Griffin Road after Anglers on your left-hand side. You'll see the sign. Shuva Israel. Shalom, shalom.